demonstration I do to demonstrate the effect temperature has on the rate of diffusion. And as you can see, right now, I have water that is on the hot plate that is coming to a boil. I have some ice water back here that we're going to use. I'm also going to use potassium permanganate, but any dye could work just the same. I like this because it's purple. You also want to make sure that you're using proper safety equipment. Potassium permanganate can stain, so you may want to make sure that you wear a proper lab apron or lab coat. You also want to wear your safety goggles. And for touching the hot liquid, you want to make sure that you have some safety, heat-safe gloves or some sort of grasper that is okay for heat. So on the left of your screen, I'm putting my beaker that has the hot water in it. And on the right is my ice water. Now I'm going to take the ice water and I'm going to pour the water off of the ice so we don't have any ice. We just have the water. Now notice that we have more of the hot water, so I'm going to take some of this hot water and pour it out. Remember, we don't want the amount of liquid to be a variable, so I'm just going to pour some of this off until we get it roughly the same. Okay, I would say that's roughly the same. So, on the left, you have the hot water. On the right, you have the cold water. For the null hypothesis for this lab, it would be something like there will be no difference between the diffusion rate in the hot water versus the cold water. And of course, your alternate hypothesis, diffusion rate will be faster in hot water. Your next alternative, diffusion rate will be faster in the cold water. I think all those are really excellent. If you write if-then hypothesis, if I put potassium permanganate in the hot water, it will diffuse faster. That would work as well, too. So let's test this and see which one is going to diffuse the fastest. Now I'm going to use equal amounts of potassium permanganate in each one. I'm going to try to do this as quickly as possible so we can see what's going to happen in both of them. This is cold first, and then hot. And let's see which one of these diffuse the fastest. I think you can already see a difference. If you look at the hot water, the entire hot water has already turned purple. The cold water is still clear at the top. Even though the hot water is not as dark as the bottom, the entire cylinder of water, the entire column of water, has turned purple, whereas the cold water, the potassium permanganate, has kind of settled to the bottom. I think you'll find the diffusion rate, that's what I'm talking about there, and then the cold water still is clear at the top. And the longer we let this sit, the more you'll be able to see that for sure. But I think we can safely say that temperature, an increase in temperature, increases the rate of diffusion.